Hello everyone, welcome back to my 100 most popular algorithm series. In this particular video, we are going to take a look at Leetcode problem number 21, which is merge two sorted linked lists. So we're given two sorted linked lists and we need to merge them together and return a single sorted list. So the problem statement is quite straightforward. As you can see here, we have 1, 2, 4 and 1, 3, 4 and we need to sort them. And the frequency of items will remain the same. So one is two times. So one in the merged list, the one will have two nodes, and then two, three, and then last two fours. So yeah, that's the problem statement. So let's understand how we're going to solve this. So here we have two lists. So what we'll do is we'll traverse both the lists from left to right, and whichever is the minimum item, we will also have a merged list. Which is represented by these two pointers, head and tail. So whichever is the minimum of the two, we'll put it here. So for example, here both are same, so we can pick any one. So we'll pick the first one, we'll keep it here, and we'll delete this, and we'll move L1's head will point here. Then in the next iteration, we'll pick this because one is smaller than, we'll compare their heads in every iteration. So one is smaller, then we'll keep one here. And then we'll keep on moving this. So the head of this merged linked list will always point to the head node, and the tail will keep on pointing the last node. And then one will come here. Then the next iteration, again we'll compare these two heads. Two is smaller, so we'll keep two here, and then tail will move here, and so on and so forth. So that's how we'll build our merge linked list, and we'll at the end we'll return the head of the merged linked list. So that's how you can solve this problem. Let's begin the coding part of it. So first and foremost, we need to handle both the corner cases or both the base cases where the lists are empty. So I'll just quickly make that check. So if one of the lists is empty, we'll return the second one. So if L1 is empty, then we'll return L2. And similarly, if L2 is empty, we'll return N1. Okay. Now we need like two pointers, merged head and merged tail, to keep track of those two respective things. So I'll have merged head, which will initially point to none, and then I'll have merged tail, which will also initially point to none. Okay, so now what we need to do, as I mentioned in the solution, that we need to compare these two heads of L1 and heads of L2. So for that, we will need those L1 and L2 present, right? So if while L1 and L2, okay, meaning both the nodes are alive. Now in that case, what we'll do is we'll compare them. So if L1's value is less than equal to L2's value, so whichever is minimum, so if L1 is minimum, then we'll have to pick that one. So now here we've deduced that L1 has a smaller value at its head location. So we need to take it out and inject it in the merged list. So first we need to check whether our merged head is set up or not. So it might very well happen that this is the first node that we have encountered and our merged list is not yet started building, So in that case, we will assign L1 as the merged head, the head position on the merged list, and the tail will also be L1. So if it is the first element, merge head and merge tail will both point to L1 right now. If that is not the case, which meaning we've already have some merge head, then what we need to play play with the tail. So we'll say merge. So we need to put L1 at the end of the merge list in that case. So here I've done that. Then we need to adjust the tail and tail to the next position. Merge tail equal to merge tail next. Okay, and lastly, in both the cases, we need to move L1 to the next node, because this L1's current head's work is done. It is now correctly placed in the merged lists. So we need to move L1 to the next node. Now similarly, else, so if L1 was smaller, we've done all our operations on L1. Now if L2 is smaller, we need to repeat everything on L2. So I'll just copy this entire block. and I'll just replace L2 everywhere. We need to do exactly the same thing but on the L2 linked list. Okay, so that is done. Now after this, this while loop will break when one of them becomes empty. Okay, so if one of them becomes empty, we need to check if the other one is present. So for example, if L1 is still alive, we need to, all the remaining nodes of L1 will just directly go behind merged tail. Okay, so I'll just do that. I'll put L1 behind in at the merged tail location, then I'll have to adjust the merged tail, and also I have to adjust the L1 to the next node. So this is for the L1. Similarly, if L2 still has some nodes left, then we'll do the exact same thing for L2 also. Okay, and after that, after everything, the merge linked list is ready and we need to return the merge head. So yeah, that's the code that we need to write. Let me try to verify it. Yeah, I was just trying with a very simple example. Let me try with the first one, 1, 2 and 4 in L1 and 1, 3 and 4 in L2. Yeah, it is working fine. Let me try with one of the linked list is present and one of them is missing. Yeah, it is working fine. I'll just perform the reverse case. Yeah, working fine. I'll just add one element in each of them. I'm just trying all my corner cases. Yeah, working fine. Let me try with a little difficult, slightly complex example. Okay, let me try with this. Yeah, working fine. I'll submit my code. Yeah, it was accepted. So yeah, that's how we solve this particular problem. I hope you like this coding challenge. For more coding challenges like this, stay tuned to my channel. I'll see you the next one. Bye.